General discussion on ECG in coronary artery disease. ECG changes in coronary artery disease can be in any of the waves or segments. Diagnosis of acute myocardial infarction in the emergency room still relies mostly on the ECG, though other investigations are there to supplement. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. PVA abnormalities have been described as minor ECG criteria of atrial infarction. Abnormal P waves described are M-shaped, W-shaped, irregular or notched. There can be evidence of left atrial enlargement if there is left ventricular dysfunction. Atrial arrhythmias can be observed in atrial infarction. PR segment contains the atrial repolarization wave or TA wave, though it is not usually evident. PR segment depression can occur in atrial infarction. An old article discusses abnormalities of PTA segment as major ECG criteria for the diagnosis of atrial infarction. These criteria are elevation of PTA segment of over 0.5 mm in V5-V6 with reciprocal depression in V1-V2, elevation of PTA segment of over 0.5 mm in lead 1 and depression in leads 2 or 3, depression of PTA segment of more than 1.5 mm in precordial leads and 1.2 mm in leads 1, 2 and 3 in the presence of any form of atrial arrhythmia. PTA segment was later called PQ segment and now as PR segment. PQ segment depression can occur in pericarditis associated with acute Q-wave inferior wall myocardial infarction as per a study. That study also diagnosed 5 cases of atrial infarction among the 171 patients based on ECG criteria. 2 of these patients had PQ segment elevation in 1 and AVL. Other 3 were suspected based on P-wave abnormalities. Pathological Q-waves are noted in old myocardial infarction. Following features are important in recognizing a pathological Q-wave. 1. Width of 1 mm or more. 2. Depth of 25% or more of the ensuing R wave. It may be noted that width is more important than depth in recognizing a pathological Q wave. All Q waves are not due to old infarction. Q waves may be seen in hypertrophic cardiomyopathy and muscular dystrophy. Loss of R wave progression in anterior leads is a commonly sought feature of old anterior wall myocardial infarction. But it may be noted that this can also occur in emphysema. Normally, the amplitude of R waves increases from V1 to V5 or V6, while S wave decreases in amplitude. ST segment abnormalities are common in the acute stage of myocardial ischemia and infarction. It is usually mentioned that subendocardial ischemia produces ST depression, while transmural ischemia produces ST elevation. ST elevation is an important feature of ST elevation myocardial infarction or STEMI. ST elevation, which is upsloping in the hyperacute phase of myocardial infarction, becomes convex in the evolving phase when the T wave gets inverted. ST elevation in hyperacute phase of myocardial infarction is known as Pardee's sign. ST depression in acute ischemia may be upsloping, horizontal or downsloping. Of these, upsloping ST depression is least specific and can occur as a normal variant. Downsloping ST depression is also seen in ventricular hypertrophy with strain pattern, including hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. ECG in hyperacute phase of inferior wall myocardial infarction with 2:1 AV block. There are 2 P waves for each QRS complex, indicating a 2:1 AV conduction. Upsloping ST segment elevation is seen in leads 2, 3 and AVF, that is the inferior leads. T waves in these leads are tall compared to the amplitude of the QRS complexes. ST segment depression is seen in 1 AVL V1 to V6. ST depression in 1 AVL and V1 V2 are downsloping, while those in V3 to V6 are horizontal. T inversion is noted in V1 and V2. T wave abnormalities are common in myocardial ischemia and infarction, but lack specificity. T inversions in anterior leads can occur as a normal variant in younger individuals known as juvenile pattern or juvenile T inversion. Ischemic T inversion is usually symmetric and arrowhead-like, while that due to hypertrophy strain is asymmetric. Tall T waves with upsloping ST segment may be seen in hyperacute phase of myocardial infarction, though it can sometimes be a normal variant. When in doubt, repeating ECG after a short period of observation to look for serial evolution or supplementary investigations like echocardiography are useful. This is mandatory when the clinical history is in favor of myocardial ischemic pain. Conduction abnormalities are not uncommon in myocardial infarction, as it can affect the blood supply of the conduction system, including bundle of His and its branches. SA nodal and AV nodal conduction abnormalities, including complete heart block, can occur in inferior wall myocardial infarction due to occlusion of the right coronary artery. Though new onset left bundle branch block was considered as a surrogate of acute myocardial infarction earlier, it is no longer so. Left anterior hemi block is the commonest conduction abnormality in anterior wall myocardial infarction and has no prognostic significance. Right bundle branch block in association with anterior wall myocardial infarction carries a poorer prognosis because of more extensive myocardial damage. Presence of associated left posterior hemi block implies a still worse prognosis. This is because of dual blood supply of posterior fascicle. Complete heart block along with anterior wall myocardial infarction signifies very extensive myocardial infarction and has the worst prognosis. Ventricular ectopic beats are the most common arrhythmia seen in the acute phase of myocardial infarction due to irritability of the myocardium. They progress to ventricular tachycardia and fibrillation sometimes. Ventricular fibrillation occurring during the first 24 hours of infarction is often primary ventricular fibrillation. Secondary ventricular fibrillation is that which occurs after the onset of cardiac failure and is not so well treatable as primary ventricular fibrillation, which occurs in the early phase of acute myocardial infarction. Another type of ventricular fibrillation in the setting of acute myocardial infarction is late in-hospital ventricular fibrillation. Atrial ectopic beats indicate left atrial dilatation consequent to left ventricular dysfunction. Coronary intensive care units were initially designed to pick up arrhythmias early and treat them, improving the prognosis in the acute phase of myocardial infarction. Here are the first set of journal references. Second set of journal references are here. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.